Hello everyone, John Scritchwell back here again with another video, and today I bring you another top 5. Yes, for those of you who are wondering, all you fans of my top 5s, yes, I know it's quite early to be putting out a top 5, but there is a good reason for that, seeing as how October seems like it's going to be quite busy for me video-wise, which is good for all you subscribers of mine. Basically, this week especially is going to be quite busy time-wise, so I decided, why not just put out an early top 5 and another top 5 at the beginning of this week, just to, you know, shake things up a bit. And also, it's going to be in honor of two specific things that I'm be making videos of in this week, this following week, which of course has to take place during Tuesday and Wednesday, which is all about the Arrow Season 3 premiere and the series premiere of The Flash. Yes, those two things are happening at the same week right now, so I'm going to be doing reviews on those two things, but in preparation and in love with these characters, I decided doing top 5s for both of the characters, and today I'm going to be doing my top 5 Flash villains, yes. So let's get right started. First off, this is subjective, my personal thoughts, so for all you hardcore Flash fans, in the comment section below, please give me your top 5 supervillain list, you know, because I know lots of you are super fans of The Flash, so I know you guys are going to, like, have some interesting, you know, villains to put in the list. But anyways, let's get right down to it. Coming up at number 5 has to go to Abracadabra. Now, he's one of the more obscure kind of villains, but I always liked him because, first off, I always like magicians. You know, I always was intrigued by the supernatural or, like, magical side of the DC universe. You always gotta like those kind of characters. And I always like the fact that he was, like, a kind of, like, a guy lost in time, where it's like he was a magician, where his career was failing, and, like, he became a supervillain because of it. Like, you always have to appreciate those villains who were, like, who just sucked at their prior job and decided, hey, why not just become a super villain, dude? I'm so awesome at that, why not? Let's try it out. Oh, yeah. And then you have to deal with superheroes like Batman and The Flash and Superman, and then you're fucked for life. But nevertheless, Abracadabra is one of my favorite villains. I really hope they approach his character, at least in the Easter egg, somewhere in the Flash series. You know, maybe in the background somewhere, you know, like, maybe the Flash is, like, running through, you know, Central City or something, like, super fast, and, like, in the background, like, really quick shot, you know, in slow motion, you see, like a magician somewhere, like, doing some stupid magic trick, you know, something like that would be kind of funny. But nevertheless, let's move off of that and go to my number 4 pick, which has to be Captain Boomerang. Yes, Captain Boomerang is specifically one of my faves because I always liked his character. I was always intrigued by his character. And I know there's two versions of Captain Boomerang. There's various origin stories or versions of the characters. So, but it doesn't really matter to me personally which version you go with. As long as it's Captain Boomerang, who cares? You know, I mean, like, I just always liked his character. And plus, don't you find it funny that he's a supervillain of the Flash mythos that bases his whole character and name on a novelty toy that no one gives a shit about anymore? Like, isn't that funny? Like, and cool at the same time? I don't know. I always thought it was pretty interesting. Captain Boomerang is just funny. I don't know. Just look at an image of Captain Boomerang throwing a boomerang at the world's fastest man alive. Fucking Christ. It's just hysterical. But nevertheless, I always liked him. And plus, you can always see him in, like, various stages in the DC Universe history, you know. You see him in the cartoon series, you see him in various movies. He's also going to be featured in Arrow Season 3, and in a crossover with The Flash, which is going to be interesting, to say the least. And of course, he was featured in the last DC movie, which was Batman Assault on Arkham, which is basically a Suicide Squad movie. So if you really like the Suicide Squad and Batman and, you know, the Arkham games, check it out, because there's Captain Boomerang for you, folks. Nevertheless, let's move off of that and go to number 3, which is going to Captain Cold. Yes, the man himself, the leader of the rogues, yes. I always liked Captain Cold, but he was always, like, a character that I had to learn to love, you know, because at first I thought he was kind of stupid and simplistic for a Flash villain. I mean, like, how is a character who can control ice with these stupid guns is going to affect the, you know, the world's fastest man? I mean, like, this guy is faster than Superman. How is he going to stop, you know, oh, a guy with, you know, a parka and you know, a visor and stupid guns. Like, how is he going to stop that? It's so easy. But over time, you get to really like his character. You get to love his character. You know, and he's been sticking in there forever. You know, and he always has this bitter, like, relationship with Flash. And not even Barry Allen's Flash, but, like, all the Flashes. You know, like Wally West and Bart. He's always had a terrible, bitter relationship with various Flashes. Specifically Barry Allen. And I don't know, I just like it, you know. And plus, you always gotta love ray guns. Who doesn't like ray guns? If you're a science fiction fan and a comic book fan at the same time, simultaneously, you just gotta love ray guns. Ray guns are awesome. Any kind of gun that can do anything, like x-ray vision, you know, heat vision, ice vision, invisible I don't know, fucking any kind of gun that has a specific ray that can do diabolical things. You just gotta love it. It's always on a poster of any kind of sci-fi fucking geek's room because of it. If it's awesomeness. So, I don't know. You just gotta give it up to Captain Cold. He has an awesome ability. And in the new 52 version, apparently he has the ability to actually use ice instead of actually use the guns, which I kind of feel is kind of sad, but what are you gonna do? And also, he will be featured in the series. Yes, he's going to be featured in, I think, the fourth episode of The Flash, if I'm not mistaken, which is going to be pretty badass. I'm pretty sure they're going to go New 52 version, you know, route with it, but, I don't know, just throw in a ray gun in there. I just want to see that, but nevertheless, Captain Cold's a pretty badass character, even though he wears a parka. Anyways, moving off of that, let's go into number two pick, the most badass of badasses. And you probably already expected this to happen, but you know what? I just had to put him out there again. And you probably know who I'm talking about because he was also in my top 5 DC supervillain list. And that has to be the ape himself, Gorilla Grodd. Yes, Gorilla Grodd's always been one of my faves. He's just a badass. I'm just saying, coming from an ape fan, I'm a humongous ape lover. And I don't know if that sounds totally fucked up or just really weird, to say the least, but I just fascinated by apes. They're just awesome. I mean, like, anybody who does not laugh or at least have a chuckle or like some kind of lighthearted moment with like a monkey just needs to be slapped. I mean, like, you can't look at a monkey and not feel happy. I mean, granted, they can eat your face off, but what are you gonna do? You just gotta love it and cherish the moment. And gorillas are awesome too, and apes, there's so many various species of apes is just so fucking badass, and Gorilla Grodd's just my fave. He's just a badass. He has this telekinetic ability. He's a super genius. He's super strength. And again, gorillas already have like superhuman strength alone, so it's just more awesome. And he can talk. I mean, just, come on guys, apes who talk, just scary. And this is coming from a Planet of the Apes fan, so obviously you know why I'm coming from. You know where I'm coming from, rather. God, he's just so badass. Just saying, if you do not like Gorilla Grodd, I don't know why you're even listening to me. Anyways, Gorilla Grodd's just on there. He's just a badass. One of my favorite supervillains. I love apes. And he just scares me. Like, there's a specific list of characters in the DC Universe that scare me specifically. You know, you have, like, Darkseid scares the shit out of me. The Joker scares that shit out of me. You know, and also I like him too, but what are you gonna do? Nevertheless, Gorilla Grodd's also on that list. He just, apes who talk and who can kick your ass scare the fuck out of me. I'm just saying, that's why I love the Planet of the Apes movies, because it scares the shit out of me. I'm just saying, an ape, a gun, and a horse, and they can talk at the same time, shit's going down, and it ain't gonna be good for me and you. So I'm just saying, Gorilla Grodd's just one of my personal favorites. If he was in the real fucking world, people, if he was in the real fucking world, we would be so fucked. So fucked. He would create his own utopia without us. We would be fucked. But anyways, let's move off of that and go into honorable mentions. The Rogues, also got to put there. Fucking Heatwave. The Brother Grimm. Wither Wizard. Trickster. Mirror Master. Heatwave. I think I already mentioned him. Captain Boomerang, the other version of Captain Boomerang, obviously. The Owen version. And that's going to be it. There's also, you know, various fucking supervillains in Flash's Rogues Gallery, but, you know. And also Zoom, you know. I mean, that's kind of a cheap shot. What are you going to do? Whatever. Anyways, I know there's other, like, various fucking characters in Flash's Rogues Gallery, but I don't know. Most of them are kind of unknown to me, and some of them are really obscure that pretty sure all of you don't really remember or know. So let's just move off of that and go to my number one pick, which has to go to the man himself, Professor fucking Zoom. Yes, the reverse fucking Flash, the arch nemesis of Barry Allen or the Flash, whatever. I don't know. I always liked his character. He's also in that era of where like DC was trying to like just do opposite versions of their superheroes. You had like your Green Lantern, and then you had your Sinestro. And that's what they did with the Flash. That you had the Flash, and then you have Reverse Flash, who's basically just has different colors, and he's also evil, and he has this evil look on his face. He's always pissed off. But I don't know. I always liked him. He's just so badass. I always thought his relationship with Barry Allen or the Flash in general was always interesting. It always intrigued me. His abilities were also pretty awesome. I always liked the fact that he can like control time and alter time and space as we know it. And I don't know, just overall the abilities that he has is just so awesome. He's just so cool. He's badass. He's evil. He hates the Flash. The Flash hates him. They just hate each other. And also, he will be featured as probably the main bad guy for the Flash. And you know what that means? Time travel, bitches. Yes, the CW's The Flash is gonna be deal with it. It's gonna deal with some fucking time travel, and I can't wait for that. I'm just saying, time travel, the Flash, shit's going down because we all know what happens when you speed super fast at an instance, specifically Superman style, like around the world, like a billion times. You change time or you go back in time, whichever the fuck. I don't know what the fuck. Nevertheless, it's super badass to know this type of stuff, and I can't wait to how they approach their relationship together. We all know that, the Reverse Flash, he is gonna be in the Flash. But it's almost unknown, like it's a mystery. It's like, who is Zoom? Who is Professor Zoom? We know who he is, but how is he gonna be approached in the show? It's gonna be some seriously, tomfoolery going around, and I don't even know why I use that word, but nevertheless, I don't know. I love Professor Zoom. He's just a badass. And also, he was in Flashpoint Paradox, and that's a badass movie. Nevertheless, that has been my top five Flash supervillains. Yes, folks. I hope you guys enjoyed. I've been rambling far too long. It's night. I'm fucking tired, as I can tell, as probably all of you can tell. I mean, my eyes are pretty much shut as they are. I'm just tired as fuck. I can't stop talking. Anyways, in the comment section below, please let me know what you thought about this personal list. Did you like this top five? If you didn't, if you did, I don't care. In the comment section below, let me know. And of course, what's your top five? I'm pretty sure tons of you have awesome lists. So please let me know what your list is in the comment section below. And of course, subscribe to my channel if you've not done so already. Trying to get to 200 subscribers, so anything can help the cause of reaching that goal by the end of the year. So please help me out. And I will be reviewing the episode pilot of The Flash. It's going to be coming out on Tuesday, if I'm not mistaken. Yes, it's going to be out on Tuesday. And I cannot wait for that. That's going to be a perfect day, I hope. And that's going to be it. And my next top five is going to be all about Green Arrow. So definitely check that out. I'm probably going to post that either tomorrow, on well, not tomorrow, but maybe Sunday or Monday. Most likely Monday will be the day I post it. But nevertheless, I hope everyone has enjoyed the specific top five. And this has been John 12.